Evening all, no respawns, hope you're doing well. So we are at Kingsport Lighthouse, and in this video I'm going to be repairing the house. To an extent, as I said, I've done similar videos before where I've repaired houses and I try and do them all a different way. In this one, it's more of a case of kind of reinforcing the pre-existing house. What I'm doing right here is I'm making the back entrance, because as you remember on the last video, my idea for this settlement is what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be treating the main house, the lighthouse, and the kind of pier dock area as separate areas, separate builds. So with the house, for example, it's kind of self-contained, so you've got that main gate with a barricade, and at the back entrance here we're having actually a powered door. The idea being is I'm going to have like a kind of barricaded walkway leading up to the pier and the lighthouse. That's the vague idea. What I'm using right now is using the Unlock Settlement Objects mod, which has some reskinned textures of the traditional steel pieces, so it's going to be quite cool. I quite like how this turns out. It looks quite grand. I initially was going to do a little bit more repairing of the roof, but it didn't really work. It looked a little bit silly, so I've kept it kind of patched up. You'll see what I mean, and you can kind of be the judge of whether you like it or not. But I'm overall quite pleased. It's actually weird. It's like this is the second video I've done in Kingsport, and already I could effectively leave it as is right now, as its own standalone settlement if I wanted to, but for the sake of requests, and also because it is quite an elephant in the room in terms of what are you going to do with it, I am obviously going to do stuff with the lighthouse. I'm kind of trying to think of it now, but we'll give that one a bash on the weekend. So quite simple, really. I've kind of gone for a just kind of reinforced metal entrance. I would have made it normally, because I do this the same kind of thing in Sanctuary, but normally I make it a lot thinner than this. Like, it's usually kind of a single square deep. However, due to the little steps in front and everything, it just made it a little bit harder to do it this one. So I just thought, fuck it, and just opted for a bit more of a bigger reinforced entrance. Now, I do decorate a little bit in for the tour. I kind of got a little bit carried away, and I was going to do like a completely full high detail decoration, but then I realized that I was kind of getting distracted from the main settlement. So I will do a main tour video after we finish the entirety of the settlement, and I will go back into the house and add more bits. But every room has quite a lot of furniture in there, but I was going to go a little bit over the top. But then I got back from the office today and I was like, I don't have time to do that. On the subject, as I want to update my last video, I got paid today, which means I went to Games Workshop and was intending to spend £30 on paints and modelling tools and end up spending £80 on 80 modelling tools, which is grand. Oops, no regrets. So good. And I also ordered my Dark Angels models off the internet. I got them on eBay. Highly suggest, by the way, if those of you are thinking to get into hobby, particularly Games Workshop, have a gander at what miniatures are available on eBay. Specifically, look at the feedback the sellers have, because the one I ordered from, I haven't got the models yet, so I will update, but he had amazing feedback, and it was actually, because I'm going a Dark Angels for, so these were the plastic Dark Angels from the old Dark Vengeance box set from, I think, 2014. So I've got the plastic Dark Angels librarian, the chapter, the company master, and I've got a tactical squad, because they have like this kind of snap fit Dark Angels tactical squad. So it'd be very cool. And that was only £30 for all of them, which is obviously still expensive if you take a step back for a hobby. However, for two HQ choices and a troops, pretty good, pretty good. And I will try and update. So follow on Instagram or Instagram at norespawns, in fact, because I'm going to be posting pictures of what I do. I've also dug out my old Terminator Chaplain, which I forgot I owned. It's like the newish one that you can buy off the store, off online, and I just dumped it in nail varnish remover so I can repaint it. So he's going to be in the army too, which is going to be grand. Anyway, on that little tangent there, so you see I've got my wee turrets. I end up having to take a lot of this off because I want to end up putting a pallet down. I want to do, in the decoration stage, I am actually going to do a lot more kind of junk and chaff needs to be added to this entrance, I think, because it's a bit blocky. I don't know why I just didn't take these stupid boxes off straight away, but whatevs. But it's a bit blocky, but I am going to do, there'll be a lot more details on it, but it's just, it's more just, I'll slowly walk around it when I do the tour, so you can get an idea, but it's nothing that really requires a video. It's just, I added some flamingos and put loads of junk shit leaning against it. But these kind of like little entranceways are quite nice. I also, one thing I haven't done because I couldn't be bothered, but I will do it. It's just annoying. I've got a switch on the outside, but I don't have a switch on the inside yet because that's painful. And also I might try and do one with the logic gates. That was one feature that I've just been completely ignoring. So maybe we'll see. Or I'll just do my traditional one, which just has loads of wires. So it's pretty straightforward. Then we've got the weed door. Oh wait, no, I'm going to do the pallet. I lied. I'm doing the pallet first. All right, we're doing pallets now. Yeah, we'll do the pallet door afterwards. It looks grand though. Looks so good. Yeah. I love it when I start a new settlement. I get really excited, especially one that I didn't expect to enjoy so much. Like Bunker Hill, as you lot know, I'm kind of like annoyed at that a little bit. I'm going to try and just finish it off soon. But for this one, it's one of those ones I'm like, oh, this is actually quite fun. Now, these windows were really good fun. So what I've gone and done is I've used this bit, except I eventually center it because it looks a bit bollocks as is. And then in the Unlock Settlement Objects mod, Andrew CX has kindly graced us with some rather funky looking boarded up window bits, which I demonstrate how I use, and then I do the rest of the house outside of the video, just because it would be nightmarish seeing me do every single one, because it's literally the same thing over and over and over and over again. But you will see in a moment. But this one window I do board up with various bits, just because it's way too big to use the boarding up bits kind of on their own. But it looks pretty decent, I think. I do have a little bit of a feisty trouble with these wall bits, as you can see, but I do get through, and you can see, I get them in the end with much... weird texture glitches as well. That freaks me out when that happens, but it's all right. It only happens when you're scrolling through the menu. Certain items, when you go over them, basically makes it do that. I've got to say, I do weirdly like boarding up windows. There's something oddly nostalgic about it. I think it's just because it harks me back to, you know, the early videos when basically it was just how to board up Sanctuary. Basically, you just sort of board it, really. But now I have more tools to board it, as you can see. And it's all grand. And I loves it. I loves boarding up windows. It's great fun. So I'm going to put a texture up there, put this one over the front to add a wee bit of texture. And then I remember, then I forgot that I had to do those windows. But it's all right, because with the power of editing, I can edit about the part where I open the menu really slightly. But I did have to scroll through the entire thing again, but it sped up, so it's fine. So see, we got quite a lot of options as well. Now you do kind of, basically, so I show you these two, and then the other ones that said I do kind of outside the recording, because it would just be tedious. And there's a vodka bottle, by the way. But it's quite straightforward to do, but it's worth paying attention that you can only really do it to kind of single scale windows. It looks a little bit weird on double windows. So with the double windows, like that main one there, you're best off using kind of wood bits, standard wood bits, and then just kind of putting these bits over the top to kind of break up the texture a little bit. That's my advice. On the other side of the building, and I will point out when we do the tour, is due to the angle of the window, there is a little bit of clippage, because I had to use three of these kind of within close proximity, but it looks all right. And the great thing is, it looks awesome from the inside. Like, this is really quite heavy RP build. RP boarding up, that's it. Whatever. RP boarding up. So what we'll do now is I'm going to do a... This is me just kind of figuring out. So basically what I wanted to do, and I'm pleased with how it works out, and I've got to add more details on it, but I wanted a kind of a walkway, just like a walkway along the side, right? So I realized already, because I cut out like 20 minutes of footage, lol, but I wasn't able to board up the roofing in a way that looked cool. Now what I'm doing here is I'm using the nav mesh repair rugs, as you can see, because I'm eventually going to put a guard post, one of the guard post mats, actually on top of where the, like, on this little walkway here. I don't do it now, because I forgot, actually, to be a frank, I should have done it in the decoration. Oh well, but you'll see it in the tour, it's fine. Like, the full main tour when I do it. However, yeah, so, like, this way should be, ideally, that my settlers will be able to walk on this little kind of makeshift bridge thing that we make, just because it gives them a nice kind of view of the entire settlement, and it looks cool. Really weird thing, and it's sped up, so you may not notice it, but I'll highlight it. For whatever reason, I think it may just be because the roof is there. You see how high that is? I was having real trouble, and you might have trouble if you try and mimic this as well, was when you place items down, they're going to be floating here. And I think it might be due to the proximity of... You see what it does there? It's trying to, like, go up. I do eventually get them, and then I'm really clever, because I'm super clever in a minute. And I actually just remove me mats, and it slots in perfectly. So I'll wait for it, because it's super clever. It totes is. Totes my goats. It's not super clever at all. Normally, it doesn't work. There we go. See, there we go. It's perfect. But for whatever reason, look, see, just random items will float. So it's a little bit of a pain. So mimicking this might be difficult. But it is pretty straightforward. It's got a wee shack bridge. I was going to make it a bit more of an ostentatious little kind of bridge with, like, kind of little walls that maybe people could crouch behind. But I did try and it looked a bit shit. So I thought I just wanted kind of a wee bridge at the side that, you know, maybe someone has a bit more of a look-see over. I decided against doing any guard towers just because I thought they looked a little bit silly. See, it looks fine here like this. Because it's quite a small little courtyard area, and just having a big-ass guard tower would look a bit odd. And especially because you've already got those little barricades that people can look out over. So I've got this for kind of like where my snipers are, watching the road. And then you've got... Don't worry, I do have it supported as well. Look at those windows as well. Oh, 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 suits you, sir. Oh, suits you. Bit of fast show. Oh, sorry. I do that every time I see something that looks cool. I do it to myself. I just kind of sort of monologue to myself. Kind of like I'm doing now, alone in my room, to be fair. Oh, well, don't worry. It's a bit late, sorry. I'm really excited to paint my Warhammer figures, people. Do you not understand? I want to paint them now. I got a little... Because the seller for my models I'm getting right is based in London. I got the email saying they dispatch really quickly. They're meant to come on Saturday, but I totally think... He's based in Wimbledon, right? So I genuinely think he'll come in earlier than that. I hope so. Because I want to see if... using eBay was a wise idea. I think so. But also, I really want to paint my Dark Angels now. It's cool. It's grand. Now, what I'm doing here, because just... I do snap the bottom bits on, just the record. But for whatever reason, normally, it's easier to do it this way. So, pillar glitch these underneath and then snap the pillars underneath. You'll see what I do in a sec. I love these pillars. These pillars are bay. I've mentioned that before, but they're really useful. I also really like the Ghoul Settler. She looks cool. I like Ghoul Settlers. There we go. And we can just kind of snap them on. I actually forget you can snap them on. And I try and do something else first. And then I just kind of experiment. So you'll see me casually scrolling through menus in a minute. Just thinking. This is my thinking scrolling. You can see this is how my brain works. I go back and I'm like, I'll give it a try. And I thought it would be... Oh, look, they snap on. Look at that. Boom. Except for this one, which is being a twat. Because this is my life. Don't worry, I get it in eventually. It just sort of decides and changes its mind. I try and, like, pillar glitch it in like this. It doesn't work. And this is like a little bit of a drama unfolding here. And I'm like, oh no. Oh no, whatever shall I do? No one will love me anymore. God damn it. And then it just snaps in. Because why not? It just wanted to be awkward. It wanted to be special. Right, so here is something that a couple of people messaged me about and just said, how do you do that? And it's like, it's really simple. So it's just a windmill. And I pop it on a rug. And then I moved it inside, and that's all I did. That was it. I was going to do something a bit more fancy, but I just wanted something poking outside the roof. And because I've got the sea nearby, a bit of renewable energy, I doubt global warming's really too much of a problem anymore. Or climate change, it's kind of already changed a little bit, what with the nukes. However, it looks cool, and it's sustainable. And I have it pointing. I even remembered to point it in the right direction as well, so it's actually facing the sea where the wind would be coming from. So there we go. And it's pretty simple. Just wire it off, and then the tour is coming. So it's very simple. I decided to keep it quite low-key. Very, very straightforward. Just a little bit of boarding up, and kind of adding these kind of key features. This is me. I wanted to get all fancy with the switches, but it wasn't really working. But yeah, here we go. I do a nice slow tour in a sec. So here it is. I've added a few turrets, and I've done quite a bit of decoration, but I was going to go, like, really OTT with the junk decoration like I did, you know, my RV video. But I will go back and do that. I just didn't want to get too distracted. But it's still, like, almost fully decorated, which is cool. I just want to leave a little bit for theming when I actually do the full tour. So as you can see, you've got my doghouse. I like my little mishmash farm. Those bathtubs, actually, you can't actually... farm them, but they look cool. And I've got my little... That's my garden, by the way. See, I've got the fungus and a couple of plants and shit. Those are the barricades I was talking about. I'm actually going to put guard mats on them, or at least have a mod that, you know, places standing guards. There's not more farm. It's really good. That razor grain, for whatever reason, was so sensitive when I would do the select all peeler glitch that I had to be, like, really far away from it. Here is the part I told you about the clipping with the boards, by the way. See, it just kind of clips a little bit just through the sides, but normally it's fine. I use those Christmas lights because they're grand. So as you see, like, the decoration is very, very just kind of, like, quite sparse, as if you'd find it in the game, but normally I'm going to make it a lot more cluttered. Quite simple, I could have spent hours doing that, and I want to kind of don't want to do all of that in one big go. So the next one will be us probably doing the windmill, the lighthouse. This is just some stuff from Aslam's workshop decoration pack, that table I just wanted to show off. Looks cool, but you can't actually place anything on it. Well, you can, but you can't in the workshop, which is a shame, because I kind of wanted to decorate it a little bit. Here's my little entranceway. Oh, I'm going to go upstairs first. Oh, I use in the experimental section, you see, I've got bath water. If you go in USO, he has the description of how it works. Really simple, but it works wonders. So I've actually got a bath with water in it. This is amazing. But anyway, hope you guys like this. Give you a few ideas. As I said, we're going to do the next video. We'll do the lighthouse or the pier. I've decided which, either or one of them. And then we'll do the other one afterwards, as well as obviously some Fortnite videos, because I've still got loads of videos planned for that. And it'll be all grand. Here's my little peeking area, so he can watch your work. It's really creepy, but we're also going to have like a garden and everything. It's going to be totally grand. But yes, anyway, as always, follow me on Twitter at norespawns. I will have a new video up very soon, and you guys enjoy the rest of your week. You take care.